State your name, my brother.
Yeah, I am Bassia Fia from Senso Studios, Iowa, Nebraska's first black comic book company.
He said Bassia Fia?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I'm glad I got that right and didn't fuck that up. Where you from?
So I'm from Des Moines, Iowa, born and raised.
All right, what's your nationality, though?
American.
What's your ethnicity?
I'm mixed.
Goddamn. You know what the fuck I'm getting at.
So my ancestry comes from, more immediately, on my dad's side anyways, is from Nigeria. And then prior to that, it was the Hebrews that immigrated from Israel that went into Africa.
So, okay.
Yeah.
That went into Africa?
Yeah, yep. So, yeah, like in 70 AD, Rome laid siege to Jerusalem.
Yep, yep.
Scattered a bunch of people out of Israel and everything. So, there's all kinds of historical documentation.
This is about to be a great conversation! Yeah,
there's all kinds of historical documentation and stuff that shows, that exodus and then even as far down as South Africa, where there's tribes of practicing Hebrews. So, but there's also, documentation showing that in Calabar, the slave trade hub in West Africa, there was Hebrew names on the documentation of the slaves that they were putting onto the ships.
Yes, sir.
And all that stuff. So,
you saying you wanted the ones that came on the ships?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, so you know how it is.
Yeah.
Andres know how it is. What's up, Andres?
I cannot hear a thing y'all are saying.
Here.
So, ask that question one more time, and then I'm going to step out. Unfortunately, because this looks really lit.
You're going to rock the headphones.
All right.
Because I can hear you.
You can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear both of y'all.
All right. We're good.
All right. Okay. This is a lot better.
Yeah, a lot better.
That better?
Yep.
You can rock with that?
Yep.
No doubt.
Fucking with it.
Hell yeah.
I'm gonna try to put together everything that I heard.
Okay.
So you're from Des Moines.
Yep.
And your nationality is again?
I'm American, but my ancestry is immediately from Nigeria, West Africa.
Okay.
But then prior to that, it goes back to the Hebrews that fled Israel, across history, but that fled into West Africa.
That's dope.
So yeah.
So you're the first generation here?
Nah, bro. We came on the slave ships. We've been here for a minute.
Okay, yeah. Bet. Okay, so what do you do? You rap?
I mean, I do a little bit of that, but that's just for fun. So I started Iowa, Nebraska's first black comic book company. It's the premier black comic book company in the Midwest.
Okay.
Senso Studios. So just focusing on bringing authentic representation to sci-fi and graphic novels and stuff like that. And I actually got a partnership with a professional race car driver.
Okay.
And we're working on this book right now. We got a crowdfunder going. So everybody go check that out on my website, SensoStudios.com.
Tap in.
You can grab a copy of the book on there, pre-order it basically, but then you can also get all other kinds of rewards and stuff with it. But yeah, so we're working on that, and then we're also getting like an animated trailer made for it, so then that way we can, pitch it to places and try to get it turned into a movie.
Okay.
And then at the same time, separately for a different story that I got, I'm working on, I'm talking to Lion Forge Animation about turning that one into an animated series.
Okay.
So, yeah, so I got a lot of stuff in the works.
Sounds like a lot, man. How do you make those connections? I'm just curious.
By the grace of God, honestly. Like, it's just, I just go to events and do my thing. And then I'm just asking around and trying to show people what I'm doing. And then you'd be surprised, like, how many people knows a guy
that's right.
Does a thing or that has a cousin that, what I'm saying?
That's right, man. That's dope. How long you been doing that?
So officially, I started the company February 1st, 2022. But I've been building out this the universe for my main IP. I've been building that out for probably like 5 years now. So
wow.
Yeah.
Sounds like a lot, man. Hustling every day, man,
Yeah.
And that's the thing that us industry sound does. We like to bring people together because there's one thing that we all have in common is we all hustle. We all have a goal in mind, This is one of the many things that we like to do. We like to put shine on the people that are really out there working. Lots of props to you for that, man.
I appreciate you, bro. Yeah, it's definitely a grind. A lot of late nights, a lot of traveling and stuff. I'd be hitting comic cons and stuff like that and going around and whatever, I'm based here. I got my logistics officer and one of my editors is in Omaha.
Okay.
And then I just made an acquaintance at in the Twin Cities that she's a publisher, and so but she's also an editor and she's a writer. So like, we're gonna be talking about getting her on the team as well. So I'm gonna be in Iowa, Nebraska, Minnesota, and then I just got after I solidify that, you know, I'm beginning into Wisconsin and stuff because I got some family and stuff up there, and there's Comic Cons and stuff up there too that I could be hitting. And so then, you know, after I do that, I'm gonna be really focusing on like Illinois and Missouri, and you know, it might not happen in that order, but you know, those are the states that I'm kind of, you know, focusing on right now. So really just taking the Midwest and you know, letting people know, you know, black creators, nerds of all, you know, from every walk of life, that this is where you go for good quality black content.
Hell yeah. Did you go to college?
I took some classes, but like, I don't got no degree or nothing.
Absolutely.
Life is the best educator for me.
Now why'd you leave? Why'd you drop out?
I didn't even drop out. Like, I just took a couple classes just of what I needed.
Oh, okay.
And then, but, you know, it's
you
a
never,
scam.
You never intended to.
Yeah, nah.
You just
nah.
wanted to.
I just
wanted.
Yeah. I took a writing class. Not that I needed it, but like, it definitely helped me refine. Not, you know, I'll say I needed it. It helped me refine my craft, you know, and get some of that formal education. But for the most part, in my experience, when, you know, just when you're out doing it, that's where you learn like most of this stuff. And then, you know, having mentors and building relationships and stuff like that. Because really all a college degree does is it puts on paper, hey, I know how to do this.
Yep,
but,
that's right.
Agreed.
But what I found is that if you can just show somebody that you're already doing it, then it's not
paper doesn't mean.
Yeah, it's not theoretical at that point. It's like, okay, this person has the paper that says they can do it, but you can see that I'm already doing it.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Not knocking college or anything, you know, if that's what you do, it's good.
No.
But
hey,
yeah.
Hey.
Stay in college. Stay in
school. Fuck college. Fuck that shit. It is a government hustle.
It definitely is.
We live in a country that charges you to be intelligent. Can't rock with
it. But at the same time, though, if you know how to leverage it, though, you know what I'm saying? If you know how to leverage it, it can really be. But there's so many other options, though. It's just people pump it like it's the one size
fits all. But it's leveraging you at the same time, though. You know what I mean? Like, it's putting your ass in debt.
Yeah, yeah.
The country is telling you, hey, go to college or you're going to fail. And then it's charging you to do so. Like,
yeah. No,
if that ain't a hustle, I don't know what the fuck is.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, it's not. If you don't go to college, you're going to fail, because there's trade schools, there's internships, there's all kinds of other stuff that you can do other than college. But college is a route, like, especially for some careers, like, you can really only do that by going to college. But there's other stuff, like, you can only do it by a trade school, or you can only do something else by just starting in the industry, being an intern, or, you know.
A lot of trade schools are hands-on schools. Yep. You know what I'm saying? A lot of tech schools are hands-on schools. The majority of people don't learn by sitting in front of a chalkboard and whiteboard, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like, no, you didn't progress your business by watching somebody show you step by step on a fucking whiteboard, do this, this. Am I wrong?
Nah, yeah. Like, that type of education is supplementary. Like, it's so. I just, I'm about to wrap up my time at the Drake Business Accelerator at Drake University. But that's not like, I'm not like enrolled in the school. That's just a program that they have. But it has experience. Business professionals that can show you, like, hey, this is how you put together a business plan, this is how you can pitch to a bank, this is how you can do this, like, stuff that is difficult to learn on your own. So, like, but that's supplementary to me running the business, you know what I'm saying? So that, like, it has its time and place. But I mean, like, if I had a mentor that could show me all that stuff, I wouldn't even have needed the program, you know what I'm saying? So building relationships is really like the best skill that you can have.
Absolutely.
Agreed.
Oh, without a doubt. You only do everything when you don't know somebody that'll help you do it for you.
Right. Yeah, exactly. And that's where I'm getting at now, too, is just meeting other people to delegate some of the stuff out. Because there's a lot to do.
Absolutely. What's your name one more time? Tell them what you got going on.
Bossy Afia from Senso Studios, Iowa, Nebraska's first black comic book company, the premier black comic book company of the Midwest. Got some new books that'll be coming out next year. Also working on some animated projects and whatnot. So definitely go on my website, SensoStudios.com. Follow me on every social media platform you got, at Senso Studios. It's two I's in that. Or you could just type in Iowa black comic books and I'll pop up on Google. I'm highly Googleable. But yeah, go check out the crowdfunder that we got. There's a button for it on my website, so y'all definitely go check that out. And yeah, grab you some books, join the community now, so that way by the time I'm popping up on your Netflix suggestion list, you already got something of mine that's signed, you know what I'm saying, on your shelf that'll be worth a couple thousand. So yeah.
Absolutely. I appreciate you hopping on, my brother.
Thanks for having me, dog.
It's great meeting you, man.
Yeah, likewise. Yep, thank you.
Andreas, what we got coming up next, dog?
We have some more shows coming up. Got some more shows. You know, we are here at Champs Club and Patio, brought to you by Industry Sounds. My name is Andres, and I'm a producer engineer here at Industry Sounds. And I tell you, man, I love it. I love to see, you know, the whole hustle. I'm all for it. You know, never knock anyone's hustle, man, because you just never really know where people end up. Yeah, I love it. I love them. You know, the vibes is right. The vibes is right, man.
No doubt. Let's get the next one.
Bet.